Welcome to this spoken tutorial on DSpace statistical report configuration. In this tutorial, we will learn to generate a statistics report, schedule the generation of a statistics report, display the number of item submissions in communities and collections. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04. DSpace version 6.3, Gedit text editor, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other editor or browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have a working internet connection and installed DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Have archived items in the collections and have administrator's authority in DSpace collection. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. The commands used in this tutorial are in a file in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the file before practicing. I have opened the code file in the Gedit text editor on my machine. And I will use the same file to copy paste the commands during the demonstration. You may use any other text editor of your choice. The shortcut to paste on the terminal is Shift, Control and V keys. DSpace offers a basic web statistics package and offers the following statistics. Information on page views, searches performed, user logins, and errors and warnings. By default, DSpace doesn't generate statistics reports. Statistics reports are generated by running scripts. Scripts generate statistics reports by parsing DSpace logs. Scripts can be run manually or as a scheduled job. Statistics reports can be accessed only by the DSpace administrator. Let us begin to generate statistics reports using scripts. Initially, let us ensure that by default, statistics reports are not generated by DSpace. Open a web browser. Go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with administrator's authority. Then click on the Logged In tab at the top right corner. Select Administer from the drop-down. Administration Tools page opens up. Click on the Statistics tab in the navigation bar. A message is displayed saying, "There are currently no reports available for this service. Please check back later." So, we have verified that by default, DSpace doesn't generate statistics reports. Now, let us learn how to generate statistics reports using scripts. Open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt and T keys simultaneously on the keyboard. Ensure that you have root permissions to run the commands. Here onwards, please remember to press the Enter key after typing each command. Now, we will log in as user DSpace. Type sudo space su space hyphen space DSpace. If prompted, then type the password of the admin user to log in. DSpace offers facilities to generate the following types of reports. Initial report. By default, monthly report for each month from January 2005. Starting month and year are configurable in the dstat.cfg file. Monthly report. Monthly report for the current month. General report. Aggregated report of all the months. Switch back to the terminal. Let us parse the DSpace logs to prepare the data for the creation of initial reports. To do so, type the command as shown. If prompted, enter the root user password. Type the command as shown to prepare the data for the creation of monthly reports. Similarly, prepare the data for the creation of general reports using this command. Now, let us proceed to create actual statistics reports using the data prepared in the previous steps. Type the command as shown to generate monthly statistics reports from the starting month and year. Generate current month statistics report using this command. Similarly, generate a general statistics report with this command. Now let us proceed to access and verify the generated statistics reports. Switch back to DSpace. Reload the statistics page using the reload button of the browser. If your session has been logged out, please log in again. Statistics report is generated and displayed. By default, the general report is displayed. The general report is aggregated from January 2005 till date. Statistics page shows these reports in different sections such as General Overview, Archive Information, Items Viewed, All Actions Performed, and many more useful sections. Monthly reports are available from January 2005 onwards. Monthly reports can be viewed by clicking on the respective link of the monthly report. Let us view the monthly report for August 2020. To do so, click on the monthly report of 08/2020. Statistics report of all the activities in August 2020 is displayed. This is how statistics reports are manually generated and verified in DSpace. Manual generation of reports is not a good practice as it is subject to human errors. It is possible to automate report generation at a scheduled time of the day, week, or month. We will create a bash script to generate monthly and general statistics reports. And we will automate the execution of the bash script using crontab. As initial reports are already created, we will not automate initial reports generation. Let us automate the generation of general statistics report on a daily basis. Switch to the terminal. Type this command to create and open the bash file general-report-generation.sh in gedit. You can do so in an editor of your choice as well. If prompted, enter the root user password. An empty general-report-generation.sh file opens in the text editor. Type the commands for log parsing and general report generation as shown here. Save and close the file. Set executable permissions to general-report-generation.sh file with this command. If prompted, type the root user password. Type this command to set the ownership of general-report-generation.sh file to DSpace user. Now, let us schedule the execution of the general-report-generation.sh script using crontab. Type the command as shown to configure crontab jobs. If you are accessing crontab for the first time, the system will prompt to enter a choice of text editor. Type 1 to set Nano Editor as the preferred editor. But you can set any other editor of your choice as well. The default configurations for crontab are shown. The format of crontab is minute, hour, day of month, day of week command. The permitted values for fields in crontab are as shown in the table. Switch back to the terminal. We will schedule the generation of general statistics report every day at 1:30 a.m. To do so, Type the command as shown at the end of the file. The value of the minutes field is set to 30 and the value of the hour field is set to 1. To execute the script every day, fields for day of month, month, day of week is set to asterisk. You can schedule report generation time as per any time of your choice. Save the configuration by pressing Ctrl and O keys together. Press Enter to confirm the save. Close the configuration file by pressing together Ctrl and X keys. CronTab, installing new CronTab message is shown on the terminal. That means the execution of the general-report-generation.sh file is scheduled and automated. General statistics reports will be created every day at 1:30 a.m. Next, let us automate the generation of monthly statistics reports on the last day of the month. Type the command as shown to create and open the bash file monthly-report-generation.sh in gedit. You can do so in an editor of your choice as well. If prompted, type the root user password. An empty monthly-report-generation.sh file opens in the text editor. Type the commands for log parsing and monthly report generation as shown here. Save and close the file. Set executable permissions to monthly-report-generation.sh file with this command. If prompted, type the root user password. Type this command to set the ownership of monthly-report-generation.sh file to dspace user. Now let us schedule the execution of monthly-report-generation.sh script using CronTab. Type the command as shown to configure CronTab jobs. We will schedule the generation of monthly statistics reports on the last day of every month. To do so, type this command at the end of the file. This command is entered to identify the last day of the month. Save the configuration by pressing Ctrl and O keys together. Press Enter to confirm the save. Close the configuration file by pressing together Ctrl and X keys. CronTab, installing new CronTab message is shown on the terminal. The execution of monthly-report-generation.sh file is now scheduled and automated. So, monthly statistics reports will be generated on the last day of every month. Now, let us further configure dspace to display the number of submissions in community and collections. Switch back to dspace. Click on the Home tab in the navigation bar. Scroll down and locate communities in the dspace section. The community's names and logos are displayed. But the number of item submissions in the community is not displayed. Also, the number of item submissions in the collections is not displayed. dspace.cfg file has a configuration to display the number of item submissions in community and collections. Switch to the terminal. Open the dspace.cfg file with this command. If prompted, enter the root user password. Locate the section Settings for Item Count Strength Information. By default, the value for webui.strengths.show is set to false. Set webui.strengths.show value to true. Save and close the dspace.cfg file. Let us rebuild dspace to update these changes. Now, dspace rebuild is successful. So let us proceed to verify the changes. Switch back to DSpace. Click on the Home tab in the navigation bar to refresh the page. Observe that the number of item submissions in the community is now displayed. So, we have successfully configured DSpace. It displays the number of submissions in the community and collections. With this, we have come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learnt to generate a statistics report, schedule the generation of a statistics report, display the number of item submissions in communities and collections. As an assignment, generate initial, monthly, and general statistics reports. Configure and display the number of item submissions in communities and collections. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by the Ministry of Education, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.